So, shall we begin?
Upon its release, Star Trek Into Darkness was mired by controversy for the decision to cast Benedict Cumberbatch to play the role of Khan. While JJ and company tried their best to keep this casting choice hidden until release, it was nonetheless the worst kept secret regarding Star Trek at the time. Before we go into the Beta-Canon explanation regarding Khan's appearance in the film, I want to first introduce the character to those who may be unaware. In the Star Trek timeline, Khan was born in India sometime in the year 1970. His mother, the director of the Chrysalis Project, died on May 18, 1974. From then on, Khan lived under the supervision of the Superhuman Genetic Augmentee Program's director. Eventually, Khan and his fellow augmented humans seized control of over half of the Earth. They were defeated eventually and sentenced to exile in space aboard the cryoship USS Botany Bay. This is where the original Star Trek series picks up. The character of Khan was brought to life by veteran actor Ricardo Montalban during the episode entitled Space Seed, which aired in February 1967. Montalban, a Mexican-born immigrant, had many notable roles, including Armando in the Planet of the Apes and playing Mr. Wark in Fantasy Island. So from the start, the character of Khan was being played by an individual who shared a different ethnicity to the character's backstory. There are several reasons for this. One is the availability of Indian actors in America during the 60s. There was an already established precedent of casting actors to play different ethnic types and groups. And Ricardo Montalban wasn't high demand at the time, so the Trek team was probably glad to get him on board for just even one episode. But that was a different time in history, over 50 years ago, and people believe we have changed a lot in that time. So when the news broke about Cumberbatch playing Khan, there was a lot of outrage about why the studio wouldn't cast an Indian actor. So from a real-world perspective, Robert Orci, one of the writers for Into Darkness, went on record and saying, quote, "Basically, as we went through the casting process and we began honing in on the themes of the movie, it became uncomfortable for me to support demonizing anyone of color, particularly one of Middle Eastern descent or anyone evoking that. One of the points of the movie is that we must be careful about the villain within us, not some other race." And some folks bought this explanation, but most people did not. As for Trek canon, there is a beta canon answer that is revealed in IDW Publishing's 2014 comic entitled Khan. So let's walk through issues 4 and 5, which cover this particular backstory. After completing his mission to destroy Praxis, John Harrison, or rather Khan, has returned to the secret Section 31 installation. With his memories just recently being restored, Khan hatches a plan to hide his remaining Botany Bay crew members inside of experimental torpedoes he developed months earlier. With his crew secured, Khan confronts Admiral Marcus in his apartment outside of San Francisco. During this discussion, it is revealed that a Section 31 deep space survey ship discovered the Botany Bay. After towing it back to their secret installation, Marcus chose Khan to be revived so he could help with their war effort against the Klingons. However, before being woken up, Marcus instructed his medical team to alter Khan's features to look more Northern European and to wipe his memory of who he was. Marcus's intent was to alter Khan's physical appearance so much and to create an entire new identity for him so as to prevent his memory from ever returning. Ultimately, this plan failed. Now, it's important to note that this comic was published in 2014, while the movie was released in May 2013. So this comic does come off as an attempt by some to try and reduce the controversy surrounding the movie and the decision to cast a white actor in a character who should have been played as an Indian actor, his role. I'm not sure that this comic actually lives up to delivering an answer as to why it is that the production staff made this decision. Anyways, that is the both real world and beta canon explanation as to why Khan looked, number one, white, and why he looks so different than the Khan we remember being played by Ricardo Montalban. So, I open this now up to all of you. What do you think about these two different explanations? Do you think that Robert Orci is right in saying that they shouldn't have cast, they should have stayed away from casting anyone who looked remotely Middle Eastern, and then potentially as them as the villains, because that would have been too damaging for their reputation as a film industry, or that it would could have damaged the profits of the film. Do you think that was right? Or do you think that it was a pretty good idea to have them do a IDW comic where they essentially explained a little bit as to why it is he looked so different from the one that we remember inside of Space Seed and The Wrath of Khan? I'm curious to hear what all of you guys and gals think about these reasons. Do you think they're good? Do you think they're bad? Do you think we even really need one? Do you think that they should have just cast a well-known Indian actor for Into Darkness? I'm really curious to hear what all of you guys and gals think about this. So please throw a comment down below. And if you enjoy the video, throw a like and subscribe up on the old YouTube and follow me on Twitter at RealKowalski. And I'll see all of you guys and gals next time. Live long and prosper, my Trekkies!